We're going to look at how you can configure your web app so that you can use your own URL instead of the azurewebsites.net URL. And as we go through all of this, keep in mind that while I'm going to be using the term web app, everything that we'll talk about also applies to API apps, mobile apps, and function apps. So I have a web app here, and it's called Jim's App, and I can browse to this by browsing to jimsapp.azurewebsites.net, so that's great. But what I'd really like to do is use a URL that's my own instead of using the azurewebsites.net URL. And I can do that by configuring what's called a custom domain name. So I've got my web app open here in the portal, and I'm going to scroll down in the settings section to custom domains, and I'll click on that. Now I have two options here. I can buy a domain name if I don't already own one, or I can add a host name for a custom domain that I already own. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to add a domain name that you already own. So the first thing I'll do is click on Add Host Name. And in my case, I own the domain name jamescheshire.com, and I want to use that with my web app. So I'm going to go ahead and enter in the hostname box here, jamescheshire.com, which is the domain that I want to use. And now I'm going to click on Validate. And what will happen when I click this is Azure App Service will go out and check and make sure that I've set up the necessary entries for that domain in order to add it to my site. Now, I haven't done that yet, so what you'll see is what happens when you haven't configured anything. And if I scroll down here, I see that I have a domain ownership error, and it tells me in the box right here what I need to do to fix that problem. So it says I need to create an A record pointing to the following IP address, which is right here. I'm going to go ahead and take that IP address real quick here and copy it to my clipboard. And now what I'm going to do is go out to my domain registrar, and I'm going to create that A record. Now, if you don't know how to do that, you can click the link right here and it'll give you documentation on that. I'm going to show you how you can do it in GoDaddy because that's where my domain registrar is. So I'll go over here to domain details. This is the GoDaddy website. I'm logged into my domain and I'm looking at my DNS zone file right here for the domain that I'm trying to register. And I've got an A record right here that currently points to 1.1.1.1. I'm going to edit that. And I'm just going to change that IP address to the one that the Azure portal gave me and click Finish. Now let's go back over to the Azure portal real quick and see that I also need to create a text record pointing from jamescheshire.com to jimsapp.azurewebsites.net. So let's go back over to GoDaddy, and I'll scroll down the list here to my text records, and notice I don't have any, so I'm going to add a record here, and then I'm going to point my jamescheshire.com to jimsapp.azurewebsites.net. Now, an easy way to point the host name, jamescheshire.com, is just use the at sign right here. And then I'm going to use jimsapp.azurewebsites.net. All right, I'll click Finish. Now I've made both of those changes. I'm going to click Save Changes here in GoDaddy. And that's going to update the DNS system. Now that change may take a little while to propagate. I'm going to go back over to the Azure portal real quick, and I'm going to attempt to validate this again. And normally this will propagate pretty quickly and this will work. If it doesn't work after making those changes, you just have to wait a little while and try again. So I'm going to click validate here. And now down at the bottom, notice that I have an OK for both domain ownership and hostname availability. I'll just click add hostname right here now. And now I see over here that jamescheshire.com has been added as a host name for this site. So now I can browse to jamescheshire.com and get to my web app. Now the other thing I want to do is I want to also be able to use the www subdomain. So I want to be able to go also to www.jamescheshire.com and get to my web app. So I've entered that now in the host name box, and I'll click validate for that. And this is going to check to make sure that I have configured my domain properly for this particular subdomain, and I see that it was unable to find a CNAME record. It's asking me to add a CNAME record pointing to gemsapp.azurewebsites.net. So let's go back over to GoDaddy and do that. I'm going to go in here back to my zone file. And here are all of the CNAME records. Now, the host for this is whatever subdomain I was trying to map, in this case, www. And then I just need to point that to gemsapp.azurewebsites.net. So let's go ahead and create a new record here for that. I'm going to just click Add Record right here. And then I'm going to change the record type to a CNAME. And the host, again, was the subdomain I was trying to map, which is www. No dots or anything, just the www. And I'll point that to gemsapp.azurewebsites.net and finish. And then I'm going to save that change. So now let's go back over to the Azure portal. And I've got the www subdomain already entered in the hostname box here. So let's go ahead and try to validate this again. And now we see that I've got a green check and an OK on both of the verification options here. So I'm going to click on Add Hostname to add that hostname to my site. And now you can see that I can browse to this site using either the www.jamescheshire.com or jamescheshire.com.